I'm a champion. Welcome to CBS Sports NCAA Men's Basketball Conference Championship Weekend, presented by Army National Guard. On a beautiful day in Las Vegas, we welcome you inside the Thomas and Mack Center for the Mountain West Tournament Championship game between the defending champion Utah State Aggies and fifth-ranked San Diego State. You see the bracket, how we got here. It was not an easy ride for either team, but the top two seeds prevailed. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Las Vegas. Alongside former Villanova coach Steve Lapis, I'm Andrew Catalan. Evan Washburn is with us as well. We're in Vegas, but it sounds a lot like San Diego. We've got a great atmosphere and the top two seeds battling for the trophy.
Well, you think about this. This Utah State team was the unanimous pick to win the league this year. They returned everybody from their championship team. San Diego State, people thought they'd be good. They've added three first-year transfers, and what did they get? A 30-1 dream season. We have the two best teams in the conference playing for a championship today. I can't wait.
Yeah, me too. Two very different things at stake as well. This morning, our Jerry Palm has Utah State as one of his last four teams in. They are very much on the bubble. Different story for San Diego State.
Well, if Craig Smith's team doesn't win tonight, he's not. The coach of Utah State's not going to sleep well for the next 8 days, I can tell you. I'd much rather be Brian Dutcher of San Diego State waiting to see if I'm a one seed or a two seed next week.
And Brian Dutcher has the Mountain West Player of the Year on his side, Malachi Flynn.
Well, one of those transfers from Washington State, he's been unbelievable. The Player of the Year in the conference, led the league in assist-to-turnover ratio, and he's a 37% three-point shooter.
Let's not forget, Utah State, the defending champ, and last year, this man, Sam Merrill, was tournament MVP.
Well, this kid's a two-guard. He shoots 41% from the three-point line, one of the best in the country. Also averages four assists a game. He takes over games in the last 5 minutes.
Let's take a closer look at this matchup in our AT&T Fast Analysis.
Well, for San Diego State, it's always about that defense, and it's a packed-in man-to-man defense. They don't force a lot of turnovers, but you can't drive it. But they do what great defensive teams do. They help the helper. They are ready to help each other out at every time, and then they end up with steals and get some layups. And then for Utah State, it's about the big man, Namish Keita. If you have not seen this kid play yet, you're in for a treat. 7 feet, can score inside. He had 21 points in that semifinal win yesterday, but he also has 5 blocks. He anchors them on offense and defense.
30-1, San Diego State trying to lock up the Mountain West Tournament title against the defending champs. CBS Sports coverage of the Mountain West Championship is sponsored by Buffalo Wild Wings. Get here for basketball and wings. Buick, proud partner of the NCAA. And by Progressive, save when you bundle auto, home, or motorcycle insurance. Game three of our triple header today on CBS. It's the Mountain West Tournament Championship from the Thomas and Mack Center in Las Vegas. Teams are being introduced on the floor, and we'll introduce you to the third member of our team, Evan Washburn.
Andrew, what's going on? So San Diego State 30-1, a possible one seed. Tough to find a blemish on that body of work. But one concerning trend, at least the last 2 weeks, it's been slow starts. They last led at halftime on February 16th. And as recent as yesterday against Boise State, guys, they were down 16 at half. You talk to Brian Dutcher, head coach of the Aztecs, he'll tell you it's a lack of defensive intensity to start games in recent weeks. But also tell you He trusts his mature team to know when to turn it on, and they've proven to do that. But this is something that could be an issue as they take on more talented teams today and in about 10 days.
Yeah, Evan, he had a great line to you Thursday after the quarterfinals after they beat Air Force, and Air Force shot 60% in the first half. And Dutcher said, I told the team, don't let anyone shoot 50% anymore in the first half, and they listened to me. Air Force shot 60%.
Well, think about this. Last four games, they're either trailing or tied. That's the longest streak in the nation to win games down or tied at halftime.
Here's a look at the starting lineups, and a man to keep an eye on for Utah State is Abel Porter. He was not able to go more than 5 minutes last night because of a back injury in the semifinal win over Wyoming. Craig Smith, the head coach, told us pregame they were going to work him out and see how much they could get out of Porter, who is their point guard. And here is Craig Smith in his second season. And the defending champs has not lost a game as head coach in the Mountain West tournament. In fact, this is his ninth year as a head coach. And he's made the tournament championship game in six of those 9 years. Baylor lost earlier today. A lot of people have Baylor as a one seed, along with San Diego State, Kansas, and Gonzaga. When we met with Brian Dutcher last night, he said, if we win this game, we should be a one seed in the NCAA tournament. Do you agree with that?
I totally, well, especially with Baylor losing, no question. I think they would be anyway. They deserve to be a one seed. The question is, where are they going to be a one seed? In the East or the West? Looks like the East right now.
We mentioned it earlier, but there is a large contingent of San Diego State fans who have made the short trip to Las Vegas. They've been here all week. I think a few thousand more may have hopped in the car this morning.
This is pretty close to a home game.
And Craig Smith told us, look, we're used to going to difficult venues. You look around the Mountain West, the Pit, their place, Nevada, of course, Viejas Arena, where San Diego State plays. A lot of difficult environments. They're ready for it, and they'll be facing it here as we're underway on CBS.
And you're going to see San Diego State 98% man-to-man. And as we said in the open, they don't put a lot of pressure on you. They make it very hard for you to get in that lane.
Utah State has won 12 of its last 15 games. They finished in second place as Merrill's first shot attempt is off the mark. David Hall, John Higgins, Larry Spalding are referees.
And I know we talk a lot about San Diego State's defense. Well, how about this? Utah State top 20 in defensive field goal percentage also. They are also a tremendous half-court defensive team.
Here's Johnny Wetzel trying to go to work early. Kicks it out. Extra pass to KJ Fagan. Fagan was the hero in yesterday's semifinal win with 21 points.
I thought it was interesting there, Andrew. They doubled Wetzel. They got a shot blocker like Kata. You don't want to leave these shooters open from San Diego State. When you double Wetzel, you're leaving a shooter open probably.
Here's the seven-footer Kata around Wetzel, way off the mark, out of bounds. And we're waiting for the call. It's going to stay with Utah State. In the quarterfinals Thursday, Utah State on their two-point field goal attempt started 9-for-9 in the win over New Mexico. Last night against Wyoming, they started 8-for-8, but they missed their first two-point attempt here against San Diego State.
You know, that out of bounds, that's one of those tough calls. It's a good thing we can go to the monitor in the last 2 minutes.
Merrill catch and shoot three, book it. Wow.
And that was with KJ Fagan, who is a tremendous defensive player, in his face.
The only player in Mountain West tournament history with more points in the conference tournament than Sam Merrill, Jimmer Fredette. Merrill has been lighting it up in Vegas as Malachi Flynn cannot answer, and Kata secures the rebound.
He missed that shot because Kata was there waiting to block that thing.
Rito three ball won't go.
I think San Diego State needs to push it a little bit. They don't play a fast tempo because they want to beat Utah State down the floor before they get set defensively.
Fagan misses another three.
They took 36 threes last night in that game, Andrew. Makes 15 of them.
San Diego State did. And the win over Boise State, as Evan mentioned, they were down 16 in the first half last night. Merrill short on the three, and Matt Mitchell grabs the rebound. San Diego State's only loss of the season came on February 22nd at home against UNLV. Wetzel blocked. Cada, such a monster presence inside.
He really is one of the better presence in the country. That's a great move with the left.
Wow. Wetzel, though, on the second chance, puts the Aztecs on the board.
You know, that's a graduate senior against a younger kid. He took it right to him with that left hand, put the shoulder in his chest. That's a bad pass.
Jordan Shackle intercepted it. And here comes Fagan in transition. Around Bean, reverse lay in. No. Wetzel, another offensive rebound.
That's two missed layups because of Cada.
Aztecs reset. Shackle, a good three-point shooter. Greg Smith told us they have to get out on Shackle. Flynn, jumper won't go, and Bean, who's the second best rebounder in the league, grabs that one.
Yeah, how about this kid's a walk-on? He averages a double-double as a sophomore, Justin Bean.
And a whistle and a foul. That's going to go on Shackle. Sam Merrill, what a season it's been, and what a career he's had at the Mountain West Tournament. At least 20 points in five consecutive Mountain West Tournament games, tied for the most in tournament history with Jimmer Fredette again.
And you know, Andrew, Wyoming gave them all they wanted in that game last night. In the last 5 minutes, he just took over the whole game as the point guard.
Now, Abel Porter just checked out. We told you to keep an eye on him with the back injury. Not in there right now as Merrill misses a wide open three.
Yeah, that's not like him. Top 20 in the country, three-point field goal percentage at 41.
Mitchell, deep three. Long rebound out to Alfonso Anderson.
Right now, early on, Andrew, no penetration by San Diego State at all. Settling for long jumpers. They're a great three-point shooting team, but not off the dribble.
Aztecs are 1 of 9 to start this game. Another slow start. Flynn nearly stole it. Cada recovers.
And you know, is it nerves or is it the fact that that big guy in there makes it really hard to penetrate?
You mean this guy
this guy here?
Yeah. He's tough.
He's so long and so agile. And this kid missed 10 games this year from that knee that he hurt in the summertime. So now he's just 100% healthy, Greg Smith tells us.
Second team All-Mountain West, but a member of the All-Mountain West defensive team as well. Wetzel again drawing the double. Gets rid of it to Flynn. Flynn, 15-footer. And San Diego State still ice cold to start this game.
I'll tell you, I'm really surprised that they're doubling Wetzel with a guy like Demetrius Cada in there. Wow, what a move.
You mean this guy?
This guy again.
Good start for the Aggies.
I think San Diego State has to try and get the ball into Wetzel, and maybe, since they're doubling him, kick it out. It'll create some open threes for them with that double team.
Flynn through traffic. Now Mitchell on the baseline. Mitchell in the paint, puts up the shot, and connects.
One thing about San Diego State, they are top 15 in the country in scoring with less than 4 seconds on the shot clock, and that's because they have three guys, Mitchell, Flynn, and Fagan, that can all go off the dribble at the end of the shot clock.
A veteran team that does not get frazzled, and that served them well in these situations that Evan highlighted. Getting behind early, they do not panic. Anderson on the block. Doesn't get the bounce, and Wetzel takes it off the glass. Have not had a stoppage in a while, over 6 minutes in.
Utah State switching all these screens too. Flynn saw he had Anderson on him, and he decided to try and take him. These guys look like they need a whistle.
Yeah. Well, well past the media timeout. Next whistle will be one. Merrill taking his time. Merrill comes to get it. Two Aztec defenders quickly jump out on Merrill with 10 on the shot clock. Merrill to Brito for three. Cada gets the offensive board. And they reset. Merrill, quick three. Spins around and out.
Boy, Cada's been a real presence, though, early on in this game.
Aztecs are playing in the Mountain West Tournament Final for the third consecutive year. They've won a tournament record 5 championships. Mitchell from the corner.
I mean, these are all really contested threes because of a lack of getting into the lane and drawing some help.
Brito takes it. Teams are a combined 5 of 25 and 1 for 12 on threes. We're almost into the second media timeout window, awaiting our first media timeout.
That's an open three.
And Fagan buries it.
And that came off the dribble penetration. That time Matt Mitchell using that big strong body of his to get in the lane, draw the defense, and kick it. That's a good three-point shot.
Fagan a 38% three-point shooter, and he ties the game at 7. Wetzel, great anticipation for the steal.
Yeah, you can't let Cada just catch the ball. That was great job of fronting in the post.
This guy's got to be tired.
I would think.
Fagan again. Why not?
That's why you throw the ball into Wetzel, draw the double team, reverse it quickly, open three.
Timeout, Utah State. The Aztecs take their first lead. They're on an 8-0 run. Tomorrow on CBS, what is the government doing to contain and treat the coronavirus? Hear the very latest only on 60 Minutes. Tomorrow at 7, 6 Central on CBS. San Diego State swept the season series from Utah State. In those games, there's a bit of a difference when K.J. Fagan, the Aztecs defender, is matched up with Sam Merrill.
Well, obviously, Sam Merrill gets off twice as many shots when Fagan is not on him. The other thing about Fagan is his man at the end of the shot clock, when the possession ends with his man shooting, held his man to 29% from the field. He is an elite defender for San Diego State.
Shot tracker providing those statistics. Now, Utah State has not scored in the last 3.5 minutes. They're 0 for 4 during that stretch. Substitutions for both teams, including for the Aggies, Abel Porter is back on the floor. Merrill in the corner, here's Porter. Shot clock is at 5. Anderson guarded by Seiko. Anderson had it poked away. Still waiting to see whose ball it is when we come back. 10-7 Aztecs. San Diego State on an 8-0 run. And moments ago, their head coach Brian Dutcher with our Evan Washburn.
Well, coach, after a sluggish start offensively, what woke up on that end for you guys?
We made some threes. We made a couple shots. It's a hard game. 3 games in 3 days. Both teams are playing on guts right now. So we just have to keep playing hard. Hopefully make some shots.
Coach, thank you.
Thanks.
They've made 3 of their last 5, and Matt Mitchell has been instrumental. He has scored or assisted on all 4 Aztecs field goals. Now, it's Utah State basketball, but there's only 1 second on the shot clock.
It's got to be a catch and shoot unless they get a lob inside, but Cada's not in.
Porter looking for Anderson, tipped away by Seiko, right to Flynn. Merrill gets back. Flynn one-on-one. Flynn, good defense by Merrill.
Really good defense. And Adam Seiko down this end, really good defense. He comes off the bench with tremendous energy.
Merrill, 3. Can't get it going early on. Merrill is 1 for 6, and all 6 attempts have been from behind the arc. Flynn, 3 ball is pure.
Now that's not good defense. You've got to make sure, you're Brock Miller, you've got to make sure you fight over the top of that screen and not go under it.
Flynn this week at the Mountain West Tournament, 7 of 15 from downtown. And a foul inside called away from the ball. Let's go back to that three.
Yeah, take a look at Brock Miller here. You can keep an eye on him. He's going to go under. Here comes the screen on top. And he goes under it, shackle screen. You could switch that too. It's two perimeter guys. That is too open for a guy who shoots almost 38% from the three-point line.
Flynn had a career-high 36 a week ago in Nevada. Big comeback win for the Aztecs in the regular season finale on the road against the Wolfpack. They were down 13 in the second half. Aggies need Merrill to get going. He's missed his last four shots.
I think Brian Dutcher is a little happier with his half-court defense in this first half than he's been lately.
Shot clock at five. Merrill to a cutting Bean. Sends it out to Brito. Shot clock expiring. Brito misses the jumper. Cato back on the floor. Brian Dutcher told us last night, big key today, no deep post touches for Cato.
That time they switched that screen, which is what they should have done the time before. Great extra pass. Not the guy who wants to shoot the three ball.
And he's now 7 of 22 on the year, but Flynn comes away from the pack. Shot clock expiring. Flynn almost went in. Utah State has missed its last six shots. Can Brock Miller get him going here? On the drive, his shot. Oh, and a foul is called on Trey Pulliam. You can stream CBS Sports HQ, the completely free and always on Sports News Network for nonstop highlights, breaking news, and expert picks. Download the CBS Sports app on your phone or connected TV to watch today.
You know, Andrew, to me, the way this game is going so far in the half court for Utah State, they got to get Kato touching. Early on, he was really effective, and he's a pretty good passer. So if he does get doubled, he'll be able to find somebody on the perimeter, because they're not getting any penetration now at all either.
Let's go over to Evan.
Well, Andrew mentioned Abel Porter dealing with that back injury. He's currently on the sideline. He's got what's called a Venom backpack on right now. You see that black strap thing. It's actually providing heat and massage constantly to keep that area warm and loose. This is actually a positive sign. Last night when he left the game, didn't even put that on, took himself out. He looks to try and manage this injury in this one.
I've seen Lapp play golf with that a few times before. To your point about Kata, he's 2 for 3. The rest of the team, 1 for 11.
And now you see this 1-3-1. You got to get it in the corners against this defense, because that's where it's open.
A rope, missed it down low, and Bean comes in.
There's a reason why they're the number one rim-protecting team in the Mountain West. You see it. They cannot score inside with Kata even just standing there.
Kata driving, Wetzel closes the gap. Bairstow on the attack, and an offensive foul. And Sean Bairstow, the freshman from Australia.
You can see this one coming a mile away. You got to jump stop in there and then either shoot it, jump stop, or kick it. When you leave your feet like that out of control against a team that's packed in the lane like San Diego State is, it's a guaranteed charge.
The Bairstow family, no stranger to the Mountain West Tournament. His older sister, Stephanie, played at Utah State. And his older brother, Cam, was the tournament MVP for New Mexico in 2014, went on to be drafted by the Bulls.
He was a really good player. And now the 1-3-1 once again. You got to hit the corners, or you got to attack in the V's of the zone. There, that's what's open.
And Seiko drills it from the outside.
You know, the 1-3-1 defense, I think it's a good defense to kind of throw people off here and there. But long term, I'm not crazy about it. It leaves a lot of open gaps in the corners.
Aggies have only 2 points in the last 7 minutes, trying to get something going, and Bean is fouled.
San Diego State starting to feel it pretty good. Malachi Flynn there, the Aztecs, with a 7-point lead early on the Aggies.
you flaunted.
The chance, an open look for three. Oh, baby. Time running out. Drives the lane.
Time's running out. Get to Nissan now for big savings on our entire lineup, like the award-winning Rogue and Altima. It's car buying season. Hurry to Nissan, official partner of the NCAA. Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus save $1,000 on the 2020 Rogue. Get to Nissan now.
Back in Las Vegas with our game summary. No turnovers yet for San Diego State, and you see the shooting totals for the Aggies. For more on that a moment ago, Evan Washburn with head coach Craig Smith.
Well, Coach, Brian Dutcher mentioned tired legs as a reason for maybe the struggles offensively. How do you best explain what's not going right on that end for you?
Well, we missed a lot of clean looks from our best player early on, and we'll live with those shots every day of the week. And then I thought we got stagnant there for a stretch where their pressure bothered us. I don't think we have tired legs. You just got to keep playing.
Appreciate the time. Thank you.
All right, that was quick.
Evan and Craig have a unique relationship.
No, there's been a bonding there over the last few days that I've noticed.
It's good. It's now 2 years in a row. They've spent a lot of time together.
I think Craig Smith's a smart man. You make nice with the reporters and those talking for the next 2 hours. And it's tough to say a bad word about Craig Smith. Look, they played well, but my man's got some personality.
He does.
There's no doubt about that.
He does. No question. Stephen, Minnesota native. He's in North Dakota. Last year was the Mountain West Coach of the Year. This year, it's Brian Dutcher of San Diego State. Aggies without a field goal in 7 minutes and 15 seconds.
This time, no double.
That's all off glass.
I still like the idea of no double. He made a tough shot. A little lucky you got to gather.
Dean feeds Kata inside. Missed it. And Mitchell with a big rebound. Kata slow to join the play. It's 5-on-4.
See, one thing Kata's got to do, he's got to gather himself every so often. He can rush that one. Let's see him guard a guard now. He can do it.
Pulliam shooting over Kata.
I'll tell you one thing that I have noticed about San Diego State for the last month, their bench has really given them a tremendous lift, mostly defensively, but on offense also.
It's an 18-4 run for San Diego State. And an offensive foul is called. A legal screen against Kata.
Well, they're calling a lot more of these.
Wow.
I don't even think he moved.
First foul on Kata. The fifth turnover by Utah State.
That was not a good call. That's been a point of emphasis, those handoff screens, but I don't know about that one.
That's all around Kata. He's got his hand on it. Big block by Kata. Mitchell trying to save it. He does. To Flynn. Shot and clock does not reset.
What a great job by Malachi Flynn making himself available for his man to save the ball and throw it to him.
Wetzel the flush. Trying to quiet the crowd. He cannot. All of these Aztecs fans are on their feet. Brian Dutcher told us how much the fans meant to them last night in the win over Boise. Aztecs have 7 assists on 9 field goals. They are moving the ball, and Utah State continues to struggle. They're 0 for their last 8.
Yeah, this half-court defense is really locked in today.
Kata to Bean. Mitchell, good defense. And out of bounds to the Aztecs.
Well, let's take a look and see what happened with this dunk, with this half-court defense. Look at Kata. Kata comes all the way out here. Bean's got to roll in here and give the help that's necessary on Wetzel. He comes in late, way too late, and they give up the dunk. You've got to be ready for help early.
Mitchell jumper, and Bean is there for the board.
Missing that just 77.
And a whistle inside, and a foul on Matt Mitchell.
And this team averages 77 points a game. They've got 11 with 5 minutes to go in the half. They're one of the higher scoring teams in the country, Utah State. But boy, San Diego State, I don't know where their defense has been in the first half for the last five games, but it's here tonight.
That was the second foul on Matt Mitchell, so he goes to the bench. Utah State without a field goal in its last 14 trips, and another whistle before the shot.
Hey, shooter!
It's on Malachi Flynn. 16 fouls on San Diego State to 2 for the Aggies. Brito straight away 3. And the Aggies can't buy a bucket.
And he's been playing great lately. But he's only a 29% three-point shooter on the season. But his last few games, he's been better.
Fagan with a tough 2.
That's the first time somebody has taken it right at Cato, besides the bank shot by Wetzel in the post. Took it right at Cato and scored.
And another timeout called by Craig Smith of Utah State. It's a sea of red here in Vegas. We're back with Hometown Heroes, presented by Army National Guard. San Diego State took part in the Junior Seau Foundation's Shop with a Jock program in December to help local children buy gifts for family and friends. Aztecs also took part in drills with local kids while giving back to the community. They are a big part of that San Diego community. Great crowds at Viejas Arena, and it feels like we're in Viejas Arena right now.
You know what a job Steve Fisher and Brian Dutcher have done with this program. People don't remember, this program had no tradition, zero, before Steve Fisher got there. And Brian Dutcher's been at his, was at his side the whole time. Now he has his opportunity, and what's he got? 30-1.
There is Steve Fisher, most wins in school history. Watching as a fan now after he retired. But his son, Mark, continues to be a special assistant to the head coach. Mark is here with the team as he continues his fight against ALS. Shackle, guarded tightly by Miller, up to Flynn. Takes a screen from Wetzel, lost it, but right to Fagan, deep 3. And Bean skies in for another rebound. That's his 6th of the first half.
You know, San Diego State is shooting 36% from the field, and they're up 13. So when you shoot 36% and you're up in a championship game, you're doing pretty good.
They haven't turned it over still, Steve.
Exactly.
That's been a big part of it for
and
them.
They're playing one of the best rebounding teams in the country, even on the glass.
Cada stepped out of bounds. No basket. Takes us to a timeout with 3:39 to go in the first half. Aztecs have it rolling just off the strip here in Vegas.
Deep dunking.
Counted in the foul. Yanni playing a sweet tune for the Aztecs. And that's the second foul on Cada.
You take a look at how deep Wetzel has Cada here. He ducks him under the basket. He's got both feet in the restricted arc area. As good a shot blocker as Cada is, you cannot stop somebody that deep.
The three big transfers for San Diego State. Wetzel from Vanderbilt, Fagan from Santa Clara, Flynn from Washington State. They did not come from winning programs. They came here to San Diego State to win. And as Brian Dutcher told us, they know they can go to the NCAA tournament. They can go to the NBA. Look at Kawhi Leonard. This is a school that has a lot of history, and these three players wanted to be a part of it.
And think about this, Andrew. Three brand new pieces, and they're 31-1. Brian Dutcher has done an unbelievable job.
Great pass and a turnover.
Trey Pulliam on the weak side. They were fronting the post. He came in to help because he saw what was going on.
Shackle splits the D. Missed it. Easy opportunity there for Jordan Shackle. 25-4 run for the Aztecs. Merrill has not attempted a shot until here. And finally, a bucket for the Aggies.
I mean, and with all that, I mean, they can't play any worse. They've held San Diego State to 27 points with 2 minutes to go in the half.
That was their first field goal in close to 13 minutes. Wetzel. And Kata, playing with two fouls, gets the rebound.
They were lucky that time. Merrill switched, and he was on Wetzel. He had him down low, and he missed.
Merrill, three ball. There you go. And Brian Dutcher calls timeout as Merrill scores a quick five.
Don't sleep on this guy. Just when he's not doing anything, he'll do it. 27-16, San Diego State.
Coming up on AT&T at the half, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, Seth Davis break down our first half, plus highlights from around the country. Coming up on AT&T at the half. Ryan Dutcher's team has won 30 in a row when leading at the half.
Well, I'll tell you, if Utah State can get this inside of 10 for the halftime, man, they got to be really happy.
Flynn nowhere to go, so he puts up the shot, and he's well short. Aggies trying to build a little bit of momentum here as we approach 1 minute to play. Merrill looking for more. He's got it. Seven in a row for Sam Merrill.
And here's what we're seeing, Andrew. Sam Merrill is one of the more effective pick-and-roll players in the country. And he is pick-and-rolling now and pulling up, and San Diego State not doing a good job with that.
Here come the Utah State fans. Fagan knocked away by Miller. It'll stay with San Diego State. So we showed the stat that Merrill hadn't attempted a shot in over 7 minutes. Why do you think that happened?
Well, they started picking rolling. They hadn't really been doing a lot of the half, and now San Diego State not doing a good job of either switching or getting aggressively over that screen.
Five seconds to shoot for Malachi Flynn.
Great defense.
O'Rourke has to put it up quickly. He does and scores as the shot clock was expiring.
Well, they're going to want to get the last shot of the half now, Utah State.
Shot clock turned off. And these fans on their feet in Vegas. Trying to get it to Merrill. They do with 10 to go.
Their defense has been spectacular in the first half.
Merrill feeling it. That's a deep three. Off the front of the rim, tipped out right to us. 1.4 on the clock. Lap, you were close to that one.
I don't know about close.
The statistician Ethan Cooperson has an assist if Utah State scores it.
I have to question your play-by-play ability if you're going to say I was close to that.
But you were on camera.
That's why I said it.
Oh, that camera? Yeah, that one again?
The sneaky camera. So who's watching us? Kata back in, Wetzel as well. 1.4 to go. Porter to inbound. Looking for Merrill, can't get it to him. They find Brito. At the horn. It's good!
Big shot at the buzzer. To get a three-point shot with 1 second to go on the shot clock to bring you to eight. This was not good defense, obviously, and they played spectacular defense for an entire half. I mean, that is way too open. I don't know what Trey Pulliam was thinking there. You don't need a steal. You just need to play solid defense there.
A 10-2 run to close the half for Utah State. And Evan is with Brian Dutcher.
Well, Coach, you controlled much of that first half. What was most concerning about what Utah State did to get back in this game?
Well, they do what they're going to do. Sam Merrill's going to start trying to get off, which he did. He had back-to-back baskets. That's what great players do in March. They try to take over the game, and he did that the last couple of minutes.
What do you like about the Yanni Wetzel matchup inside? He played well in that first half, and Kata's a big man in there.
Well, they mixed it up. They doubled early, and he kicked out for threes. Then they didn't double, and he went to work in the post. So Yanni's just got to read if he's doubled or not.
Coach, thank you.
Thank you.
That is the end of the first half with San Diego State, ranked number 5 in the country, leading Utah State 29-21. Time now for AT&T at the half. Let's go to Greg Gumbel in New York.
All right, Andrew, thank you. Coming up on AT&T at the half, Clark and Seth join me for highlights, conference clinchers, bubbles busted. All of that after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports coverage of the Mountain West Championship is sponsored by AT&T 5G. Lowe's, official corporate partner of the NCAA. And by Bud Light Seltzer, it's unquestionably good. Welcome back to CBS Sports NCAA Men's Basketball Conference Championship Weekend. Presented by Army National Guard at the half here in Vegas, Aztecs lead it by 8. Back courtside with former Villanova coach Steve Lapis, I'm Andrew Catalan. We'll hear from Evan Washburn coming up. The calling card for the Aztecs all year has been defense, and we saw that on display in the first half.
All year they've been elite defensively, one of the best in the country at points allowed, defensive field goal percentage. In this game, they're holding a really good Utah State team to 30% shooting.
As we take a look at the Dove Men Plus Care first half stats, first time this year, Aztecs have gone without a turnover in a half. And here's a look at that D, Coach.
Yeah, they give tremendous help. They always see what's going on from the weak side. They're in good position. They give you nothing easy in the lane. But for Utah State, Sam Merrill went for a long period in that half of not even taking a shot. But at the end of the half, he started getting it going again. They need him. He was the most outstanding player in the league last year, first team all-league player. They need him to get it going against this terrific San Diego State defense.
You see the shot chart of Merrill, powered by Shot Tracker in the first half, as we send it over to Evan Washburn.
And Andrew, after talking to Craig Smith, when it comes to Merrill and offense for Utah State, it's that attack. You felt like they finally started to attack in the final minutes there. Transition offense picked up, getting downhill. As for defending Wetzel, he said, we just got to not allow him to get so deep in the post when he makes his catches, and they will continue to send doubles, guys.
Well, the problem is if a guy pulls up that deep, you can't even get to him in time to double him. So Kata's got to do a better job of pushing him out a little bit. And then if they bring the double, they got to hope that they don't start making threes.
Mitchell jumper off the mark. A closer look at the box score and the Mountain West Player of the Year, Malachi Flynn, was off in that first half. He was 1 out of 9 from the floor. This has been a second half team in San Diego State, and they'll start this half with an 8-point advantage. Being down low to Kata. Nice move for two.
Well, that's what happens when you get a little bit of dribble penetration in the lane. Good things happen. San Diego State didn't give up that much of that in the first half.
Aggies have scored 12 of the last 14 in this game. Shackle can't get that three to go, and Porter comes away with it.
I think it's a good idea to try and run against San Diego State a little bit. Get there before their defense is set up.
Porter gets his man to the ground, but can't stick the shot, and here comes Fagan. 1-on-2. Fagan all the way. Missed it. Nobody to help him out, and now Merrill.
I like to see K to try and post up a little more aggressive. There's Sam Merrill again.
Such a sweet stroke for the senior from Bountiful, Utah. And the lead is down to 4.
Flynn trying to answer, and now 1 for 10 from the floor, and Merrill, who's made 4 of the last 5, brings the ball up the floor. Aggies riding the wave right now. They keep it rolling!
They need a timeout right now. That was a tough shot, well contested by a great player.
15 for Merrill.
I think they needed a timeout.
Flynn looking to answer again, and he cannot.
Not a good shot either.
7 straight points to open up the half for Utah State, and now they have a chance to take the lead.
I think Kata needs to try and post up more aggressively and in deeper in the post.
Oh, steal by Flynn. Racing up ahead with Fagan. Flynn will take it himself for 2.
I mean, that was a mistake by Kata. He puts the ball on the floor with the player of the defensive player of the year, Malachi Flynn, on him. Not real smart.
Only the second player in Mountain West history to win player of the year and defensive player of the year. The only other time that happened, Utah's Luke Neville in 2009.
Oh, that's sweet.
Air ball, though, for Merrill. Bean catches it. Shot clock does not reset, and Bean turns it over. And a foul. 10 turnovers for Utah State. Brian Dutcher's team still without one today.
Yeah, I mean, it's amazing. They have 14 more field goal attempts than Utah State does. That's because they have no turnovers.
And you see what they've done in the second half of their last 5 games. They have locked it in defensively. But a good start for Utah State here in the Mountain West Tournament Championship game.
Let's see if they get Wetzel a touch in the low post. Kata working really hard to not let him get the ball.
Here's Fagan. Puts it up from the free throw line. And a tough rebound by Merrill. He was locked up with Mitchell, and Merrill wins that battle.
And that was really good defense by Porter that time.
Merrill down low. Back up to Brito. Brito had it poked away. And out of bounds to Utah State.
I think when he caught it, he had a shot. And, you know, he hasn't been hit in this game. He decided not to shoot it. He's got to shoot that one.
Late night on CBS, what will Stevens say as the Democratic field narrows and the race to the White House rolls on? The Late Show with Stephen Colbert. New Monday after your late local news.
Kata's got to be more aggressive posting up. He kind of just stands around sometimes. Like right now, he's in the corner. Not really much use out there.
Fagan, a good defender on Merrill. Merrill, tough step back. That was good defense by KJ Fagan. But Mitchell stepped out of bounds. And that takes us to a timeout. Just over 4 minutes into the second half. And the Aggies have found a little life here in Vegas on CBS. CBS Sports NCAA Men's Basketball Conference Championship Weekend is presented by Army National Guard. Learn more at www.nationalguard.com. Top-seeded San Diego State on top of number 2 Utah State, 31-28. As we take a look at our AT&T Fast Analysis.
Well, you take a look here. This is a switch waiting to happen between Shackle and Malachi Flynn. But take a look. When they cross, when Bean crosses with Merrill, stop right there. Look how far away Shackle is. That's not an aggressive switch onto a great player. You got to be up closer so that he doesn't want to shoot the ball. That was not an aggressive switch to stop a man from taking the shot.
Merrill has 15 points. The rest of the team for Utah State has scored 13. And you see, Merrill has had some scoring spurts this week in Vegas, including the final 3-4 team last night against a Wyoming team that made some noise.
And I gotta tell you, I think one of the things they need to do is get Kata working a little bit harder at posting up, because they gotta get another scorer here somewhere.
Aggies have done a great job on the glass to begin this half, out-rebounding San Diego State 8-1.
Now Shackle's on Kata. They should be trying to get him the ball down low.
Instead, he sets a screen, tried to roll with it. Merrill couldn't get it to him. Now they feed Kato. Draws the double. Back to Bean. Lays it in.
You can play through the big guy because he's a good passer. That time Bean, they got him into the post. Bean didn't stand. He cut, and Kato was able to get it to him.
Bean has 4 points, 10 rebounds, and 4 assists as a rope goes to the ground and loses it. Numbers for the Aggies. And Merrill will throw it up to Brock Miller. That was the first San Diego State turnover of the game.
That's a bad pass and great help from the weak side by Shackle.
Aggies give it right back. Jerry Palm has Utah State as one of his last 4 teams in as Arope puts it in. What a difference the next 8 days will be like for Utah State, either knowing you're in, that feeling to enjoy, or sweating it out.
I've been in both.
Selection Sunday.
I've been in both, and the latter is definitely not as much fun as the former.
And we asked Craig Smith about that, the Utah State head coach, pregame, and he said, look, we've lived on the bubble the last 2 years. Every game we play, we have that playoff game mentality, so this is nothing new. And a whistle inside on a rope.
I think that Kata could put so much pressure on a defense because he's so big, he's got such good hands. The more you look at him, because Sam Merrill can't do it all by himself. Establishing him and playing through him, I think, is important.
Brito looking for Kata. Instead finds Miller in the corner. And an offensive foul called inside on Kata. And that is number 3 on the big man.
That's a big call. I think he's got to come out for 2 minutes. Because he cannot get the 4th.
Take another look.
Yeah, that's a foul. He held him off. That's a foul.
Flynn splits the D, and Kato that time backed off because he's out there with the 3 fouls.
Absolutely, Andrew. I kind of would rather take him out for 2 minutes.
Miller, that pass, was trying to get it to Kato, waited too long.
Well, you take a look, here's Kato here, and now Flynn's gonna drive this ball. Let's see what he does defensively. He doesn't even get a hand up, which he could have got a hand up at least.
Pulliam, the rebound off the miss. Aztecs lead it by 5. Diego State looking for win number 31 on the year. Flynn with 5 to shoot. Over to Seiko, has to put it up. He does. And there is Bean with his 11th rebound. This Justin Bean last year averaged 3.8 rebounds a game. This year over 10. It's the largest improvement in the country of any player.
That's where you want to get him the ball.
A rope knocked it away. Flynn end to end. He's swatted, but a foul is called. That's going to go on Brito.
That's great defense by a rope, one of those subs that gives such good energy minutes.
It'll send Malachi Flynn to the free throw line. For Mountain West play this year, he shot 91%. Thursday on CBS, it's never easy starting over. Be there to watch friends and family come together for the season finale of The Unicorn. Thursday at 8:30, 7:30 Central on CBS. If you haven't seen much of San Diego State this year, they are without their rim protector in Nathan Mensa. He's been out since December with a blood clot in his lung, and Brian Dutcher still hopes that Mensah can return for the NCAA tournament, and what a big difference that would make for the Aztecs.
Because really, they only have one big guy. A rope comes off the bench, he's like 6'6". Wetzel's the only big guy they have, so having Mensah would make a big difference. Here comes that pick and roll that Merrill runs so well. Good job by San Diego State that time.
Brito, man went to the ground. He locates Anderson for three. Yes! Alfonso Anderson with a big three.
And that's not what he does, but that was a big one for them.
Just a 30% three-point shooter. What a matchup. Merrill on Flynn. Two of the best in the Mountain West.
Vegas been very quiet here in the second half.
With the shot clock at five. Porter all over him. Great defense and a takeaway. Second San Diego State turnover. Rito lost it, but right to Anderson. Porter's wide open. Passes on the three. Back to Anderson for another three. It's good! Back to back for Alfonso.
Wow, talk about not completely unlikely, but relatively unlikely guy to make two threes in a row.
Junior from Tacoma, Washington. Flynn missed it, the follow by a rope.
Cater goes defensively to try to block that, and a rope, smart, knows Cater's out of position rebounding-wise, he follows it up.
In the first half, Utah State 3 of 14 from three-point land. So far in the second half, they're 3 out of 4.
They've been trying the pick and roll, but San Diego State's been playing it very well in this half.
Kata dumped it down low to nobody. And a timeout. Are we having fun yet? I mean, it's still early March, and we got it rolling here on CBS.
March equals madness.
Shoot, score.
Major
against.
Bring it on, big man.
The dream is alive.
Beyond belief.
Oh, it's coming. 8 days until the selection show next Sunday on CBS. They have the first four in Dayton on True TV. And then first and second round coverage, TBS, CBS, TNT. True TV. Utah State on that bubble this morning. Jerry Palm had him part of his last four in. And then you look at some of the things that have happened today. Texas lost. Rutgers won.
You know, the good thing for Utah State is if they do take an L today, it's going to be against a team that's number four in the net. So you got to think they're not going to move much, but you're in a position where upsets, if Dayton doesn't win the Atlantic 10, for example, there goes one other spot. So they're not going to sleep peacefully for 8 days. Believe me, I've been there, and it's not fun. All you do is say, are we in? That's it. Everybody you see, that's you. It's your wife. Yes, Gary, are we in? At least that's what I did.
I'm sure you're not the only one.
And my kids were 10 and I was asking if we were in.
That was before the days of Cherry Pop. Now you know. 3-point game. We approach the midway point of the second half. Mountain West Conference Tournament Championship game. Mitchell. Tipped around and Wetzel has it. His first rebound of the half. Still yet to score here in the second. Poked away by Brito. Great play by Diego Brito. Merrill, great move for two.
A little bit of a miscommunication defensively again. They didn't know if they wanted to switch, not switch. And that's why he was able to get the step on Fagan and get it all the way to the basket.
Big Sam's got 17 today. It's back down to one. Fagan triple off the front of the rim. He's fouled on the shot by Abel Porter.
Wow.
Second foul on Porter. Let's see it again.
That's a foul. Got to protect the shooter. just runs into him.
Mountain West Conference Tournament a week earlier than normal this year, which means for San Diego State, they're going to go until March 20th before playing a game again. And as Brian Dutcher told us, he's going to call Mark Few at Gonzaga, see how he would handle it. As we remind you that Tuesday on CBS, the hunt is on for the most dangerous criminals in America. The new hit thriller, FBI Most Wanted, Tuesday, 10, 9 Central on CBS. He also told us, Dutcher, he's going to bring in some alumni to have a scrimmage to play over the next couple of weeks.
I'm guessing Kawhi Leonard will not be one of the alums.
That'd be nice. Can we watch that?
You know what? But that's a good point that you made. They're going to sit out for almost 2 weeks without playing in the NCAA tournament. Mark Few does that every year. This guy here.
Triple for Merrill, and now he has scored at least 20 in six straight Mountain West tournament games. That is a new conference record. 20 for Merrill is 4-3. Merrill's got 20. The rest of the team has 21. Shot clock at 4. Mitchell lost it.
They didn't turn it over at all in the first half.
Now they have 4 in the second. Merrill, deep 3! Hello!
This guy here. My goodness. That is a tough shot.
The Aggies have erased a 16-point deficit. And they lead it by 2. It's a 14-5 run. Flynn for 3. He gets it to go.
They needed that, and he needed that. Fagan doing his bit. Oh, great job by Wetzel.
The steal. Wetzel trying to draw the foul on Cada. Good job by Cada to get out of the way, but Wetzel puts the Aztecs up 3.
And that was smart by Cada, not picking up his 4th there.
Merrill. And it draws the foul on Wetzel. Good play there by Sam Merrill. Wow, what a game. 7:47 to go, Steve.
But we got it all going on here. Look at this guy. The J right in the face. And then down the other end, Malachi Flynn answers back. 47-44, Aztecs.
CBS Sports coverage of the Mountain West Championship is sponsored by Experian. Introducing Experian Boost. Chick-fil-A, it's the little things that make game day worth celebrating. And by Coke Energy, energy you want, taste you love. A different school has won the Mountain West Conference Championship each of the past 6 years. The last repeat champion was New Mexico, who won 3 straight from 2012 to 2014, but Utah State has a chance to go back-to-back thanks to this guy.
Yeah, because this guy knows how to come off the screen ready to shoot the ball, and he loads it up so quickly that you don't have time. If you're going to switch it, you got to switch it aggressively. You got to be up on him because he's got a quick trigger, and he's feeling it right now.
In the first half, Utah State shot 30%. In the second half, they're at 69%, including 5 of 6 from deep.
And this has been the opposite.
Let's check in with Evan.
Well, guys, 2 huddles and 2 different themes for Utah State, all about pushing through whatever fatigue they have in this moment, saying we're tougher, we're prepared for this. As for San Diego State, all about defense, and as you guys were highlighting, how to manage through Merrill in some of those screens.
Okada with a pretty move there.
Yeah, no double there, and you know, one-on-one, he's going to be tough down there. Wetzel's got to be a little more physical with him.
What a feed, Flynn to Fagan. Brito right on him, though, and Fagan misses. Back looks okay for Abel Porter. He's been out there the majority of the afternoon. Anderson is fouled by Shackle in the paint.
You know, right now, San Diego State has a small team. They basically have four guards in with Wetzel, and that time Shackle ended up with Anderson, and you see how much bigger and stronger Anderson is than Shackle. If you let him catch the ball down there, he's going to get to the free throw line.
Top two seeds meeting in the Mountain West Tournament Final. The top two seeds have met in the final nine times, and the two seed has won eight of the nine meetings. A pattern that Utah State likes as they've tied it, and Anderson gives them the lead.
You know, Andrew, we talked about the rebounding was even in the first half, even though Utah State, one of the best in the country, plus nine rebounding margin, they're starting to get away from San Diego State on the glass.
Plus six for the Aggies. Wetzel knocks over Cade, a lot of contact,
wow.
No call.
That had to be something.
Aggies have made their last seven shots in a row. And Cade completes the three-point play.
Malachi Flynn, he's the guy.
Flynn's pass deflected and taken away. Turnover number five this half for the Aztecs.
He left his feet not knowing where he was going.
Merrill, three, short, and the rebound to Fagan. He wants to push.
Shackle hasn't got hardly any looks in this game.
Shackle's 0 for 3.
He's their best percentage three-point shooter.
Here comes Flynn on the attack. And he throws it out of bounds.
Malachi Flynn with the penetration. Merrill does a good job. There's no foul there. That's twice in a row that Malachi Flynn left his feet not knowing where he was going. That is really something that he does not do often. He's one of the best in the country at assist-to-turnover ratio.
Six turnovers in the last 10 minutes for San Diego State.
Oh, he's too open.
Misses the three, but the offensive rebound to Anderson. And a foul on San Diego State.
Well, they were lucky that Merrill didn't make that. And that was definitely a foul. I tell you what, Shackle has had all he wants with Anderson. Anderson has been, look, I mean, there's just a physically such a big difference.
Just about to say that Anderson has really provided a nice spark off the bench.
They don't really have a good matchup for him, San Diego State, especially if they're going to play small.
Rebounds continue to be tilted in the Aggies' favor in the second half, plus six on the glass.
They got a better chance now with Mitchell playing Anderson.
Porter with the shot clock at five. Porter drives off the front of the rim, and Mitchell the rebound. He's fouled on the rebound.
They really don't want the ball in Porter's hands in that situation. Shot clock winding out with KJ Fagan on him. We talked about it. His man is 29% from the field at the end of the shot clock. He is a lockdown defender at the end of the clock.
And this is remarkable. Since 2000, the number one seed has failed to win it 16 times in the Mountain West, most of any conference.
That's incredible. Mitch has been quiet, too.
Fagan steps into a three and misses, but the offensive board to a rope. Inside 5 minutes to go.
Their defense has been pretty good, too, by the way. That's a foul.
Yep. And it comes with four on the shot clock, so not a great decision there by Anderson.
Yeah, Fagan saw that he had Anderson on him. He's going to beat him off the dribble. But Utah State, they hold people to 39% from the field. They are an elite defensive team. Not as good as San Diego State, but pretty good.
Mitchell using his muscle, poked away. A foul is called. And they get Anderson for that one. Team foul number seven on the Aggies, so it'll be a 1-1. Malachi Flynn had a quick little breather on the bench. He's set to check back in. So Flynn got a breather there, Steve, but Sam Merrill has not come out of the game the entire way. Third game in 3 days. He's locked a lot of minutes. Let's see what Sam's got left down the stretch.
Yeah, this is it, obviously. You know, not having sat out at all. He is one of the leaders in minutes in the league, but 3 games in 3 days is a little different.
Third most minutes per game at 34. He brings the ball up the floor. His Aggies trying to punch the first ticket to the NCAA tournament this year. Brito feeds Bean with the left hand, won't go. Bean gets the rebound. What hustle by Justin Bean. And that brings it back out.
He was looking, he just threw that one up.
Former walk-on has made a big impact in his sophomore year. Here he is with the ball on the shot clock at 5. Finds a wide open Kata, who lost it going up. Gets it back. Gets the shot off as the horn sounds.
You're going to look at it.
They will take a look. It was very close to a shot clock violation. And while they look, we'll have a media timeout. Let's see if we can determine.
Oh, that's good. I think it's good.
They will take a look. We'll come back with the answer after these short messages. The Aggies moving closer to a spot in the NCAA tournament. It's time now for Inside March Madness, presented by Buick, and the tournament resumes for both Gonzaga and San Diego State. Jerry Palm projecting them both to be a one seed for the NCAA tournament. Do you feel like the Aztecs stay there if they lose this game?
It's going to be tough. It all depends. If Dayton runs through the Atlantic 10, they may be a one seed. If Florida State wins the ACC tournament, they could be a one seed. So it's way too early because all these other teams that are close have games. Maryland, if they go through the Big Ten tournament, they could be a one seed. So there really is too much yet. The only way they guarantee it is if they win this game today.
Let's go back to that last bucket, and they are counting it for Utah State and Kata.
Yeah, I think that was a shot. They talk about that as a shot attempt. You can't pass the ball to yourself. I think that they're saying that was a shot attempt there. It slipped out of his hand. And that's why it was not a violation that he scored in time.
So the bucket by Kata makes it a four-point game with 3:50 to go. Ryan Dutcher's team, the only one-loss squad in the country, trying to avoid loss number two here in the Mountain West Tournament Championship game.
And they have not been able to find anything really in the half court. This has been a tale of two halves in every way. But, you know, Wetzel's only got three fouls. Him being out in this situation, I'm a little surprised.
Aztecs have only scored 20 points after halftime. 22 now, thanks to number 22, Malachi Flynn.
Boy, this guy is tough with the ball.
And there goes Wetzel and Shackle to the scorer's table. Great scene here in Vegas.
Fagan is working so hard on Merrill. No double.
Kata over a rope, gets the bounce.
It's a big difference in height. A rope 6'7". Kata 7 feet.
He's got 15 points to go along with 7 rebounds. Fagan traps right at Kata, nowhere to go.
I tell you, with 3 timeouts left, I'd like Colwell to get Wetzel back in the game here. I think it's an important possession.
Mitchell, fadeaway is short. A rope cleans it up.
And he would have come in for him. That shows what I know.
2-point game with 2.5 to go. Oh, great An unforced error for the senior out of Portugal.
And you know, it wasn't, Andrew. There was a lot of pressure from San Diego State on this possession. And yes, he definitely just threw it out of bounds. But he had to work just to get open in that possession.
Aggies averaged 12 turnovers a game. That was their 16th. Wetzel back in, along with Shackle. Aztecs can't hold on to it. A struggle at midcourt. And now we have a tie-up, and the possession arrow favors Utah State.
Boy, it is like everybody on the court looks like they dove for this ball. Watch here. This is a fumble if I've ever seen one. Great hustle by all these kids. Tell you what, these guys are playing hard.
Yeah, third game in 3 days. We pointed out again, and you have not seen anyone slow up with 2:05 to go.
I give KJ Fagan a lot of credit, too. He has been really tough.
Merrill driving, tough shot, won't go. Wetzel with the rebound.
I would give Wetzel a touch on this possession, see if they double him.
Wetzel gets the touch, and he's fouled. Wetzel has his fourth double-double with 11 points and 12 rebounds today.
Wetzel is really good at slipping screens. He makes like he's going to set a screen for Malachi Flynn, and everybody's on high alert to guard Malachi Flynn, and they forget about Wetzel, and he slips right to the basket.
Native of New Zealand, began his collegiate career at St. Mary's of Texas. Then he went to Vanderbilt, and now Wetzel, the grad transfer with San Diego State.
I think if somebody told him when he was coming out of high school he was going to start on a team that's 30-1 in Division I someday, they would have said, you're crazy.
Did not start playing organized basketball until he was 17 years old. Goes one out of two at the line. It's a one-point game.
I think they should run offense. I don't like this just pounding the ball out here. Keep trying to score. It's only a one-point game.
Everyone on their feet. Merrill for three. Short and the long rebound out to Fagan.
You know, that might have been legs there, Andrew. That was a pretty good look.
And Brian Dutcher calls timeout. Each team now with two timeouts remaining. We're set up for a good finish here in Vegas on CBS. We're back in Vegas to look at our game summary. 16 turnovers for Utah State. Sam Merrill has led the charge. He's got 23. And the player of the year in the league, Malachi Flynn, 5 out of 17 for 14 points.
Starting to come on a little bit now, though.
With Steve Lapis, Evan Washburn, our entire crew, I'm Andrew Catalan. So much on the line. Not only are they playing for a conference tournament title, but for Utah State, if they don't get this game, they're going to have a very edgy next 8 days waiting and living on the bubble. And for San Diego State, a brilliant season. Most people have them as a one seed. But if they lose this game, do they drop down to a two for the NCAA tournament?
Might not be the end of the world being a two in the West, but we'll talk about that another time.
Malachi Flynn trying to get going. Connects!
They didn't guard that screen and roll at all that time. Too easy, a 12-footer.
1 minute to go.
You got to get it in Merrill's hands, you know that.
Merrill's got it in his hands, guarded by Fagan. What a matchup here. Merrill trying to take Fagan. Merrill missed it, he's fouled. Wow, Fagan D'd him up tight.
He did, but Merrill Hughes has got a little bit more size than Fagan, and he used his body. Really strong move here. That was good defense. Could have been a charge, burying the shoulder, too, to tell you the truth. Watch here. Merrill buried. Oh, that. Tell you what, that last bump is what gave him the space to get fouled.
Wow, that is something you do not see very often. Sam Merrill, just under 90% from the free throw line. And he misses the first. One out of two. He ties it at 56. And a timeout called by Utah State. with 39.4 on the clock. This has been some triple-header on CBS today, and we've got another one tomorrow starting at noon Eastern as Memphis takes on number 21 Houston. And then we have the Missouri Valley Conference Championship game, followed by a big one in the Big Ten between Ohio State and Michigan State, all here tomorrow on CBS.
In this situation here, Andrew, you got to think it's going to be a high screen for Malachi Flynn. They can't hold the ball because if they hold it for their shot clock, Utah State's going to get the last one with 10 seconds. They need to use as much time as they can to get a good shot.
A 9-second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Flynn for three. Missed it. And the rebound to Merrill.
They got to get the last one of the game.
Merrill's got to be careful. Shot clock is turned off with 20 seconds to go.
They got to take this with about 6 seconds to go, give enough time for an offensive rebound, and then overtime.
They clear out for Merrill, electing not to call timeout.
I like that move.
Tied at 56. Merrill for the lead. He's got it!
Oh, my goodness. He thinks he got fouled.
Sam Merrill has not cut
any better. As a matter of fact, he almost fouled him on top of it. That was just an incredible play by an incredible kid who makes big shot after big shot every time we see him.
Merrill has 27 today. 17 here in the second half. San Diego State calls timeout, and they do have one remaining.
Well, they got to get this ball up to, they got time. If they can make the pass to half court, that's the key here. You can't throw it in the back court. You got to try and make a pass at least to half court, maybe tip it to somebody, and you have time to get a shot. There's no question, but you got to get the ball past the half court.
And if you're Utah State, do you foul?
You got to put somebody on the ball, and yes, you've got to foul. But the problem is you don't want to foul and have the guy go up for a shot. But yes, you have to foul in this situation. You just have to be careful with this much time left. As soon as whoever catches it is going to probably try and shoot it. So it's a little bit dicey. But yes, if they catch and hold, you got to foul right away.
Aztecs have not shot the ball well from deep today. 5 out of 18 for the game, just 1 of 7 this half.
And I would put Cade on the ball. I would not have no one on that ball there. I don't like this move by Craig Smith not putting somebody on the ball.
And now Craig Smith has called timeout. He wanted to see the way San Diego State came out, and now he can rearrange his defense.
I got to be honest, you had a guy like Cada. He's the perfect guy to guard the ball. I mean, you got to, that would make it so that you got to throw a lob pass. If you got to throw a lob pass, probably not going to make a clean catch in that situation. If you don't put somebody on the ball and you can throw a bullet, that's a different story.
These San Diego State fans in disbelief. Their Aztecs have only lost one game the entire year. And a loss today could be the difference between a one seed and a two seed for the NCAA tournament. Think back to the first half when Utah State was down 27-11. They could not get anything going offensively, and now in position to lock up a spot in the NCAA tournament.
You gotta give their defense credit. They held San Diego State to 32 points after that. And then you got Sam Merrill's got almost half of his team's points in this game. Let's see if Craig Smith puts someone on the ball this time.
San Diego State has very capable three-point shooters. Jordan Shackle, 43%. Malachi Flynn, 38%. They have guys that can shoot it. What type of look do they get?
They're going to probably try to throw it to Wake. Got Wetzel at half court. He's the biggest guy. Try and throw a pass to him, and then him just turn and pass it to somebody. You have time for two passes and a shot in this situation. But it's got to be quick.
And now Brian Dutcher calls his final timeout.
I don't like it that they didn't put somebody. I don't know why you wouldn't put anybody on the ball in this situation. I just don't know what the. I know you have an extra guy playing center field. I get that. But I would rather make that guy taking the ball out of bounds, give him a tougher pass than the one he's going to have now if nobody's on.
Neither team has a timeout remaining now as Steve Fisher, the longtime head coach at San Diego State, the man who built this program, watches in the stands as his longtime assistant, Brian Dutcher, a finalist for the National Coach of the Year Award, tries to diagram a shot to tie it up for the Aztecs and force overtime.
And this is a set play that they have in their special situations. You got to be careful if you're going to foul, because they're going to try and shoot it quickly.
Mitchell inbounds. There's Malachi Flynn at midcourt. The heave. And he almost hit it. What a shot by Flynn. But instead, it's no good. And the Aggies are going back to the NCAA tournament. Malachi Flynn had a great look at it, and this one nearly went down from just inside midcourt.
And you know what, Andrew? He probably could have taken one more bounce. He kind of shot it a tad early. I think he could have gotten another 5-6 feet with one dribble and then shot it. But hey, give you give credit, that ball was halfway down.
Utah State does not have to sweat it out for the next 8 days. The Aggies are the first team into the NCAA tournament. They go back to back here in Vegas. 59-56, the final. Coming up next, Inside College Basketball, presented by Progressive Insurance. For Evan Washburn, Gene Steratore, Steve Lapis, our entire crew, I'm Andrew Catalan. We'll send you to Greg Gumbel after these messages.
And that is the ultimate game winner as we welcome you inside college basketball presented by Progressive Insurance. Greg Gumbel along with Seth Davis. Clark Kellogg has flown the coop. He'll be courtside tomorrow for Michigan State against Ohio State. We remind you, tonight on CBS begins with FBI and NCIS Los Angeles, followed by a new edition of 48 Hours. That's tonight only CBS. The game you just watched, Utah State beat San Diego State 59-56. Let's get you back out to Las Vegas, where Evan Washburn is standing by with winning coach Craig Smith.
Well, Coach, we're back here live. An unbelievable basketball game. Another Mountain West championship. How do you best put into words what this team did?
Well, back to back, and this team's been through a lot this year. Just with so many injuries and this, that, and the other. And we had a tough stretch in January, but we never flinched. We never flinched. And the late, great Jim Valvano, we watched a video that he, speech that he had. And he said, our bags are packed. Our bags are packed. And we made up our mind after a tough loss at Boise that our bags are going to be packed, and we were ready for this day. And we showed a lot of fight. Not a lot went right in the first half, but we kind of seized some momentum at halftime, and we found a way to win against the number 5 team in the country with great determination.
This game was tied, and you didn't call a timeout. You let Sam Merrill take this on his own. Why?
Well, you know, we called the timeout. We said, we're going to get a stop. Or they called the timeout. We're going to get this stop. There was a 10-second differential. And we said, one stop. We're going to get this thing, and we're going to score it, and we're going to celebrate like crazy. And they're so good defensively that you don't want to call the timeout, get it in, and now they can just load up on you and get their personnel in. And that dude right there is a big-time player, obviously a player of the year, and I just can't have enough great things to say about that kid.
Coach, you're the first team in the NCAA tournament. How's that sound?
Oh, man, we got our dancing shoes on. Back to back, Evan! Go, Aggie!
I'll let you mess with the hair, always. Sam, that's a play that I'm sure you had in the backyard growing up. A championship on the line and the ball in your hands. What's going through your mind in the moment?
I actually spent all week, you know, after we lost to New Mexico, people were saying, people were saying we might have been out of the tournament. And all week we talked about we're going to find a way to get this done. And I couldn't sleep last night because I was hoping I'd get that opportunity. I actually had a move set up, but Fagan guarded it good enough that I just had to go do a little step back and went in.
This team went to the tournament last year, won this tournament a year ago. That first round didn't go the way you wanted. We spoke about it a few days ago. How's it going to be different this time around?
I mean, we're gonna give it everything we got. Like, not that we didn't last year, but especially me as a senior, Utah State's been to a lot of tournaments, especially in the last 15 years. They haven't won a tournament game since 2001. So this is our time. This is what we're going to do.
Sam enjoyed. It was fun to watch.
Thanks, Evan. Appreciate it.
Greg, back to you. Logan's about to party.
All right, Evan, thank you very much. A couple of things about this game. Number one, Seth, rematch of last year's title game, which was won by Utah State. San Diego State won both of the regular season meetings between these two teams. Number one, only fitting that Sam, the man, took the shot. And number two, not necessarily all bad news for San Diego State.
Well, first of all, I love, love, love that Craig Smith doesn't call timeout. We are into March. If you need to call a timeout and tell your kids what to do in that situation, you haven't done a very good job over the previous 4 months. And Sam Merrill, what can you say about what he's done? 83 points over the three games in Las Vegas this week. I think Utah State still would have gone to the tournament even had they lost today, but they don't have to worry about what I think or anybody thinks anymore. They are going to be in the tournament, very well earned. As for San Diego State, Greg, I still think San Diego State is a number one seed. Remember a month or so ago when Kevin White was in the studio, did the early season bracket reveal, talked about those four number one seeds, said there was real separation between them and that number two line. Well, there's less separation, clearly. I think maybe a team like Florida State can move in. But remember now, they have to take into account the entire season. Florida State does have two quadrant two losses at Clemson and at Pittsburgh. San Diego State has lost two games all season long, and they have some pretty good wins in there at BYU. Their neutral court win against Creighton looks better now. Their neutral court win against Iowa has held up well. So you got to look at the entire body of work when we talk about these number one seeds and not just what happened here down the stretch. So my guess would be that San Diego State is still going to be on that one line. I think that Maryland, even if they win the Big Ten tournament, has probably played their way out of number one contention. Baylor is the one that's flirting with disaster here a little bit down the stretch because they've lost three of their last five, including at TCU, which was not a good loss either. And so they still have some business to take care of in the Big 12. I think San Diego State is probably still a number one seed.
If you were San Diego State, would you prefer that number one line or would you prefer a number two seed and stay home for the tournament?
A very different question and a very good question. I think they're better off being in Los Angeles as the number two seed. Their fans very easily to travel there. If you are the last number four seed on the board, or even if you're not the last, because Kansas is going to go to the Midwest, and if Baylor is a number one seed, Greg, they're going to go to the South and Houston. So regardless of where they fall in, the question is, where is San Diego State vis-a-vis Gonzaga? Now, if Gonzaga loses in its conference tournament, then maybe San Diego State can jump Gonzaga and get to L.A. ahead of Gonzaga. But I think if we gave them some truth serum, it's nice to be a number one seed. School clearly has never done that before, and it would be a great cap to the season symbolically. But as far as competitively, do you want to be in the East where you're playing a team, you know, a Duke, a Villanova, a Seton Hall is a number two seed in the East where they're going to have their fans in the building at Madison Square Garden? Or would you rather be in L.A.? I'm saying it's better off to be a two seed and go to L.A., but we'll wait and see about 8 days from now.
Meanwhile, that's a live look out at Thomas & Mack Center in Las Vegas where the Aggies of Utah State are celebrating their second straight Mountain West championship, 59-56 over San Diego State, and they are on their way, for sure, to the NCAA tournament as Mountain West champions. And by the way, with Selection Sunday just a week away from tomorrow, this gives the committee a little something extra to think about all week long.
Yeah, no question. I just want to say one thing also. I've always wanted to do that to Evan Washburn's hair. So I have a lot of jealousy right now for Craig Smith that he was able to do that.
All right, let's take a look at some highlights. See, way up there at the top, Wisconsin with a share. Maryland, Michigan State, and Illinois. Still more action to be played tomorrow, but it is becoming a little bit clearer of